In this video, I will explain you about operation modes. So what is the concept of operation modes? The demands of users on the SAP system vary during the course of the day. So the entire day, that means 24 hours in a day. So the demand of users to use SAP system may vary. So those are, during the day, a large number of dialog users who want to be served with high performance by the system are working. Therefore, a large number of dialog work processes should be available for users during the day. But in the night, however, only a small number of these dialog work processes are used, and more of the system can be used to process some background tasks. That's why you need to have more background work processes than dialog work processes. So to perform this switch between dialog and background work processes without restarting SAP instances, the operation modes concept will be used. And the concept of operation modes can be seen in this picture. That is day operation mode and night operation mode. During the day, you need to have more number of dialog work processes. During the night, you need to have more background work processes so that more of the background tasks will be performed. So the system resources will be utilized for the background operations. So that's why you need to have more background work processes in the night. And now we need to adjust the instances to the load distribution. So the instance will be available, and that is configured with the instance profile. In the instance profile, number of dialog work processes and background work processes are defined. Okay, just see, in the operation mode day, you have here 3 dialog work processes and 2 background work processes, and in the instance 2 there are 4 dialog work processes, 2 background work processes. And if you come to operation mode night, so the same instance will be switched with this type of work processes, that is 2 dialog work processes and 3 background work processes. 2 dialog work processes compulsory, that is minimum dialog work processes should be there in the each and every SAP instance. That's why you can't reduce below 2 dialog work processes or below 2 background work processes. 2 dialog and 2 background work processes are minimum work processes required in any instance. And here in the instance 2, there are 2 dialog work processes are available and 4 background work processes are available. So if your system is configured with 2 instances, so during the day there are total 7 dialog work processes and 4 background work processes, and during the night you have 4 dialog work processes and total 7 background work processes. And how to set up operation modes? To set up operation mode, you need to use RZ04T code. So using RZ04, you can create operation modes in the system. Once the operation modes are created, you need to distribute the work processes to these operation modes, that is to the day operation mode and night operation mode. And then you need to adjust the work processes to the available instances, and then you need to define the timetable, that is scheduling. So from which time to which time day operation mode and which time to which time night operation modes, you have to define this setting. So to define the setting of scheduling operation modes, you need to use SM63 T code. So SM63 T code can be used in your SAP system to define the timetable. Like if you have 24 hours time, that is 0 hours to 24 hours. Okay, so from morning, from midnight 12 o'clock to morning 8 o'clock, you can define as night operation mode. And after 8 o'clock, morning 8 o'clock to 9 o'clock, night 9 o'clock, you can define as day operation mode. And then rest of the time can be defined as night operation mode. And you can also set exception during a specific day, that is exception operation mode, that is May 1st, if you want to put some exception in the May 1st. So you can define the night operation mode for this particular day, so that no users will be working on the SAP system. That's why you need to have less number of dialog work processes and more number of background work processes. In that way, you can specify particular day as exception operation mode. And now, once operation modes are created and work processes are distributed to the operation modes, you can control the operation modes from RZ03, that is control panel. You can monitor and do consistency check from this T code. Okay, and you can switch between operation modes manually using this T code. And profile consistency checks. And once the operation modes are defined and working fine, if you want to change the number of dialog work processes using profile parameters, you can increase the dialog work processes or increase the background work processes. But once you do this increasing of number of work processes, you need to restart the instance. Then the operation modes configuration will be lost. You need to adjust the operation modes again to the number of dialog or background work processes. That means total number of work processes should be consistent. It should not be increased. Okay, you need to switch between the available work processes only. Let us see this experiment in the system so that you will understand in little bit clarity. Okay, let us log on to the system. So this is already logged in. So from here, let's let us check how many work processes are defined in this instance. Refresh. First one is background work processes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 dialog work processes are there. And update work process, NQ work process, another dialog work process is there here. And background work process, background and spool, update 2. So, just you need to create operation modes first. RZ04 is the T code for creating operation modes. So this is the initial screen of creating operation modes, that is CCMS, maintain operation modes and instances. So first let us create operation mode using this menu item. Just click on the create button here and put the name as day OP, that is day operation mode. Click on the save button here. And in the same way, you need to create night operation mode. Click create night OP, night operation mode. Click on the save button. So two types of operation modes are created, that is day operation mode and night operation mode. Okay, you need to create the instance to distribute the work processes to these operation modes. Just to create instance, click on the instances or operation modes button here, and from the instance menu click on create new instance and provide the application server host name here. Just select it and click on current settings so that it will display all the profile values here. Okay, like this. This is the profile name, this is the start profile name, this is instance profile name, and these are all the work processes are defined in this particular instance, that is dialog 10, background 3, update 1, update 2 to 1, NQ 1, spool 1, total number of work processes are 17. Okay, just click on the save button from here and immediately it will display you the message saying that profile NWD, that is instance profile DVBMGS00_NW7EHP1, does not contain any errors. Yes, this is information box. You can click on continue button to continue. Okay, and once you click on the continue, you will get this screen, that is maintain work process distribution. From this screen you can maintain the work process distribution. Okay, application server is NW7EHP1_NWD_00 for operation mode. What operation mode you want to specify this number of work processes, just select it and double click on day operation mode, and whatever the work processes are available right now, just accept and click on the save button. So as soon as you click on the save button, you will get another screen asking you to yes or no question, that is assign WP distribution to other operation modes. Yes, I want to assign the WP distribution to other operation mode, that is night operation mode. Just select the night operation mode from here and click on the increase the background work process during the night. Just click on the plus button here so that dialog work process will be decreased. So dialog work process cannot be increased by using this plus button, so you need to use background work process plus or minus buttons to vary the dialog work processes. For suppose if you want to increase the dialog work processes, you need to decrease the background work process like that. And update also, if you want to increase it, so the dialog work process will be decreased. In the same way, update 2 also, if you want to increase update 2, the dialog work process will be decreased. Okay, mainly the switch between background and dialog, that's why just increase the background work processes to maximum possible, that is 11, because dialog work process minimum 2 work processes should be there in the each and every instance all the time. Okay, you can't increase beyond this level, that is 11 background work processes are possible in this instance. Okay, once you do this adjustment, click on the save button to save the values. Okay, and it is again it is asking you the question yes or no, that is assign WP distribution to other OP modes. Just in this screen click no. So because all the operation modes are distributed with work processes. Okay, so the distribution of work processes is are over. Now you need to schedule the timing. So how to schedule it? There is a T code called SM63. From here, in the normal operation, click on the change button and the selecting times from 8 o'clock, that is double click. I'm double clicking here and up to 9 o'clock. Again you need to double click on it here so that the color of these times will be changed to black color. Now click on the assign button, select operation mode, that is day operation mode. So once it is done, and you need to select remaining times, double click here, assign night operation mode, and double click here, and double click here, assign again night operation mode, click continue. So this is edit operation mode set for normal 24 hour operation. Okay, you can also specify exception operation. You can click on change and exception operation, that is you can specify a day, that is May 23rd or some day. If the day is holiday, you can select like this. Entire time can be allocated as night operation. Actually this is optional. Okay, just for experimental purpose I am selecting this also, edit exception operation mode set. Just click on the save button. So the scheduling is over. Now the operation modes are created, work processes are distributed to the operation modes, and the exception operation mode also created. Now we need to check this operation mode switch between night and day. Okay, actually you need to wait up to the night 9 o'clock or morning 8 o'clock to make the switch, that is switch to happen. But if you want to test it out, you can use the manual switching, that is from the T code RZ03. So it is showing as day operation mode, that is active. If you want to switch this operation mode manually, you can switch to night operation mode. Before switching to night operation mode, let us check the number of work processes allocated right now in the SM50T code. Just you see how many dialog work processes are there. 10 are there. Just once it is switching is performed, we'll come back to that screen and check whether the switching is happen or not. Okay, RZ03, hit enter. And to switch to the night operation mode, just you need to double click on choose operation mode. So, and then double click on night operation mode and select the instance, click on control, switch operation mode, selected servers, and click on night operation mode. So now the operation mode is night operation mode. Just go back. Okay, enter SM50 and just check it up. Now there are 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 background work processes are there. 1 2 2 dialog work processes. So that's all about configuring operation modes. Thanks for watching.